Hello, welcome back to my channel. My name is Kim. I'm doing a past life reading for April 2018, and this is for couples. I did get a good response from the March reading, so I thought I would continue with this type of reading as it resonated with some people. I have picked a card from the past life deck, and what fell out was forgiveness. So it is telling me that the person that you were with in the past, you were with now. This could have been something that you've been trying to heal through, or you've been trying to release the anger that you stored back in this lifetime. And maybe you're not aware that you've been holding resentment from this past, so whatever happened in the past is affecting your relationship today. You may notice little subtle things coming up, like you may be addicted to alcohol, or maybe your moods are changing, or you've got blood pressure problems. But basically, you need to have more control over your health in this time. Also, it's telling you to forgive, because that's self-empowerment. It's not saying that you agree to whatever the issue was back then, but it's just so you don't harbor resentment and carry those old negative energies into your future, because you don't want to take them into the next 9-year cycle. You want to be able to move forward. So as long as you hold on to anger, it's only hurting you and not the other person. So you need to find a way to release this old anger. Maybe you're not really aware that this is happening, but this is the problem that's coming through for April. Maybe you can do some meditation online. There is some really good meditation on YouTube that can help you release old anger issues. Now, I have picked a card from the Romance Oracle deck, and you have the Soulmate card. So it is telling me, yes, you are soulmates. You were back then, and you are still today in this lifetime. But whatever the resentment is that happened back in your past incarnation has brought you to the energies of making a decision. So you've got the crossroads here in the Lenormand deck, and this is about a decision that you're facing within the next 5 to 7 weeks. Now, it is about obstacles with the mountain. Or maybe you've been delaying this decision. Maybe this is something you've been processing in your mind, but you haven't been able to take the plunge with it. Now, this could be a decision that will affect the family, or it could be a decision over two houses or multiple houses. You also have the card of the fish. So this is definitely telling me that it's affecting your emotional state. And also, this is your deep soulmate. This is a card of a soulmate connection, but there could be some choices about money, or maybe the family home. And the mountain here is what's dividing you. So maybe you're dividing the house and the money. So maybe this is what's been delayed, and it's been an uphill battle for you. Now, I have underneath the Lenormand deck is the crossing, which is about burdens. But it also can mean that you need to have faith as well, because it's coming next to the book. So this is a book of knowledge. This is the Bible. It could be just asking you to have faith in God. It is about secret burdens. And with the stork here in the reading, this is about changes that are happening to you that will be noticeable. But whatever the secret is making you move forward and make some changes within yourself. I just want to pull some more cards to see what these changes are about, or what is going to happen with those changes. So just bear with me, Leo. Okay. So you've got the card of Scythe, and this is about cutting something off. It's a negative card, but on the other side of the blunt side of the Scythe, it is about harvesting as well. So maybe it's about cutting off your temper. Maybe you've been a little bit aggressive, or you've been too much in control over money or the house and family. But it's asking you to have strength. So you need to have faith and strength and courage, so you can cut all ties to this past, even though you were soulmates. Maybe you've paid your karmic debt in this lifetime and it's time to move forward now. Okay, now I have pulled a card from the Animal Tarot deck and it's a Seven of Winter and it is the magpie. And as you can see, the magpie's got the key here in its beak and other obstacles that are in, accessories, that are in the nest here. So maybe this is you holding on to your wedding ring or, you know, your key to the house or something like that. But it's just a caution. Caution will help you avoid the loss of your valuables. So maybe it's non-material resources such as time or peace of mind. And also you've got to be aware of the results of your actions as well, what others might be doing behind your back, because you do have the card of the book, which is about secrets. So maybe people are stealing your possessions of some kind, so you need to cut all these negative energies on and move forward. I want to pull a card from the crystal deck just so you can buy a crystal and keep it on you at all times. Excuse me, and we'll see how this is going to help you move forward and heal, Leo. So I do feel like you've got a decision you're facing, and it is about separating from the family home. It's going to affect your family, but maybe it's also the sale of the home as well, and you're separating your home and your money, or the money that you receive from the home, perhaps, with this person that you're with. I feel like you've outgrown each other, but you just need to be careful to, you know, that you're going to lose a lot of valuables during this split. And it's just non-material things, so as long as you've got your health and you're able to move forward with clarity, that's more important is what I'm picking up. So just see what we've got for Leo, what kind of crystal they need to have. Okay, this fell out of the deck and it is amber. So this is about you. This is the healing card. It's also cleansing, it's giving you balance, and it's also grounding you. It's golden brown or yellow color. It's very transparent or opaque, and you can easily obtain these from crystals or new age shops. And this card fell out because it's indicating a need for balance and healing in your life. So you need to look to the past life so you can shine a light on the future. So just harboring all the resentment and anger from the past life is not doing you any good. In the healing sense, it is very good in aiding the relief of depression. So if you've been depressed of late and undecided about making this decision to go forward, it's going to help you with your mental imbalances that cause feelings of disconnectedness. I think that's how you pronounce it. So it's going to help treat the internal organs. And that's especially good for the kidneys, spleen, stomach, bladder, liver, and gallbladder, so all the organs there. And it's good for overall healing, both on physical and emotional level. So this is going to help you move forward and have more of a sunny and positive outlook in life. And its main purpose is to open the self to higher vibrations and allow the creative energy to draw upwards, and you be able to manifest what it is that you're good at. And also it's about having patience and wisdom with the book. This is about someone that's got a lot of knowledge, which I feel you do have. And it's about to be able to process of growth and evolution. So I hope this is going to help you throughout April. As I said, it's only going to resonate with a small majority of people out there, maybe even 1 to 3 people. But it is messages that are coming through from the divine, and I hope it reaches the right people, and that you can heal and move forward in April. So take care, Leo.